Okay, so you're gonna see me use the domino to plunge down in here, and I've got the domino set at 15 degrees. I had mine, I cut mine at 20, and I thought maybe that was just laying back just a little bit too much. But I think 15's a little bit better, so it gives your chisels and things that are on the outside, you know, somewhere to lay to. But I'm gonna also do some that are vertical inside here. This domino, this is a tool that every time I use it, it's another one of these Festool things. Every time I use it, I get mad, because I think back on the hundreds of hours that I've spent over the last years doing angled router work, where I had to come up with some shim angled contraption to do some angled router work. Well, this thing is a plunge router that it doesn't matter what you do, you can plunge down. You don't even have to hold it. You'll see, I'm just going to freehand this. I mean, you can set it in space on a surface at any angle and just plunge down into it and hold this handle down, and the thing's not going to move, you know. If you really wanted to create some kind of boundary, you could, but for this, I'm not even going to bother. So you can see I've got my measurements kind of laid out here, and you'll also notice that on this domino, I've got the 8mm bit in here, and I've got the plunge depth set to the maximum, 28mm. But you'll see here that this thing will change the sweep of the cutter. So this is where it would be just at the size to cut a perfect, you know, to cut a perfect domino of this size. So that's just a tight fit, like right here, you know, that would just be a tight fit. But by changing this, that sweeps it out just a little bit more. And then by changing this, it sweeps it out even more. So what I'm gonna do here, what you see is that on here I did the small, and then I did the next bigger size, and then I did the biggest. And so I'm gonna do all my small ones first. I think all these are gonna be small here on the ends and on the corners. And then as I progress inside here, I may go small, medium, large, and then back to small again. And then large, medium, and small here. But I'm gonna start the camera, and I'm gonna make all these cuts without stopping it. And I'm just gonna hold it here in the end of my Ribot. I'm gonna turn my fan back on, because it is summer in Texas, and I'm hot. Okay, let me actually pull back and give you a little bit better perspective here. I'm probably going to be in the way for some of these shots, but like I said, I'm going to cut all these, and I'm not going to stop. And then I'll stop after that, and I'll mark some more holes out. And then once I get as many domino holes as I want, then I'll go to the drill press, and I'll start opening up some hold receivers too. Okay, so I have this, I want to put this on the smallest. So all I'm going to do is just line this up with the edge here. Just freehand it. And I'm going to just pin it down like that. And then once I turn this thing on, I'm not going to stop it either. It's like cheating there. Okay, well, let me do a little bit more layout and then I'll come back and cut some more. I want to change bits and move from that 8 millimeter down to this little 5 millimeter. I wish I would have put some other ones in mine. I didn't really leave room for them for some real narrow slots for like little thin knives and stuff. So I thought I'd just take this opportunity to show you how to change the bits on the Domino. They're really pretty clever. They're a spiral fluted router type bit, but it has this threaded end on the end, and that's what's going to thread onto the shaft. So to release the plunge mechanism, you just use a wrench to just lift it like that, then the plunge mechanism just pops right out. And I always use this opportunity when I pull it out to just give a nice little dose of some good oil on the plunging mechanism here. Now, of course, this is unplugged and it has a shaft lock right here, so you just simply unthread that off the mechanism, off the shaft. You can see it's a threaded end right here, and you just simply thread the other one back on. So it's pretty darn easy, and I always just give it a little snug. I don't try to over tighten it. I just give it a little snug. That's ready to go. That's all there is to it. So now I've got this little 5 millimeter bit in here, and I'm gonna lay some stuff out on my pieces and get to work. I'm gonna put this up so I don't lose it. Okay, I've got that 5 millimeter in now, and I'm gonna switch this back. I'm gonna switch it back to 15 degrees again. Be like that, and I drew myself a register line, since I don't have that edge anymore. So I'm going to register off of this line, this one. So I'm going to plunge 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 on this one, and then on this one I'm going to just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And after that, I think that's enough domino work, and then I'm going to go to the drill press and start opening some holes up for other things like scratch awls and what have you to go in there that are going to just be vertical. I'm just lining it right up to this, to my scribe line here. That's enough. That's enough dominoes. The rest will be holes. Okay, onto the drill press.